Welcome to Empire! It's Lil. Yeah, I'm sitting here all alone because nobody likes me. Woohoo. Oh well. And we are here today to celebrate wrestling. I love you too, Benja. Anyway. So, let's, without further ado, bring out the first contestant of the day. She hails from the Royal Crypts of the Kingdom of the Night. She's 5'1". Wow, she's short. Weight 130 pounds. The Lady of the Night Rose, Yukimi. Yukimi looking very wonderful.
I was a bad clown.
Uh-oh, what did you do?
See, Emma and I were just playing whack-a-mole backstage, and it seems that, well, she didn't like it. She won't be, unfortunately, out to join us today.
Oh!
Oops.
What did you do? Did you whack an Emma?
Well, is that what you would call it? I guess since she was the mole.
Oh my. So Emma's not going to be here tonight. I thought she was.
No, I think they're still trying to figure out where to get her.
Oh, we'll find her sometime.
Anyways, I hope the rest of you enjoy the show.
Okay, so they were playing Wacka Emma.
Hit my music.
Yeah, whacking Emma. So now Emma is MIA. Oh boy. Just in, because she whacked Emma, guess what? Yukimi has to commentate with me today. You whack at Emma person, you. Alright, are we ready for match two? Wait a minute. No, we're not ready for match two. Somebody wants to speak.
Thank you.
it isn't the evilest couple of KOW.
Will you just stop talking? God, what is wrong with you? Every time I try to come on here and talk, people want to talk over me. Alright. To the point of freaking steroid user in the back who thinks he's God's gift to KOW. That's right, yeah, you, Xander Garcia. You think you beat Dominic Foley Square?
Protein?
Guess fucking what? You did. You cheated like you always do, using your goddamn swords. You know what? Dominic needs another shot at you because you cheater! Why don't you come on out, Xander? You gotta hide in the back! I knew you were chicken shit when you come out and face.
I pledge allegiance to
what the hell does this little dickwad of an American think he wants now?
For which it stands, one nation.
Oh god, is that stale beer and Cheetos I smell?
Yes, it is. Stale beer and Cheetos. Here he comes, the American! That will be Brian Bennett. The American... Yeah.
Oh, it's the American reject. And there's no pets!
I still can't get the taste out of my mouth.
This American Legion does not need his melon to talk for him. So you just sit there and make him look pretty. Cause that's what the hell if you're on, jackass? No. This time you're doing the listen, Miss Morris. I did not get beat by a steroid using wannabe baby face Xander Garcia. The referee rang the bell. I was not swimming. I passed out because I'm like these people.
I'm weak.
Yes, you need to defend me.
Out. Wow.
I'm weak, but we need to fight them kind of thing.
You know what I got? Oh, what does this slimy asshole want?
Good lord, it just keeps getting worse.
Oh, here comes Mr. Sexy.
Oh boy.
What do we have here? Brian Bennett, KOW's only whimper excuse of a redneck, and Dominic Surge, Malice's oversized, battery-operated boyfriend, talking about who should go for the crown. If the ref wasn't harassing Lacey, you would be looking at the new KOW crowned king.
Where is your good old pimp dolly going now? Cause I don't see her around you. She's too much of a chicken to come out with you.
She has other plans made.
She's on the street corner of the year.
How much does she get? A quarter of a pop?
The only person that deserves another shot at this crown is me. Brian Bennett, you can't beat me. It's been proven. And the Playboy knows that overdriven Radio Shack reject can't either.
Okay.
So why don't you two step aside and let the real man get the title shot?
Oh, God, no!
Alright, all y'all, just shut up. I got an idea. Shut up, Bennett!
I said it first, Roman.
Shut up!
I said it first, Roman.
Do you want me to knock your head off?
No.
Oh, please do.
I'll get you the match here. I'll get you the damn ring, right? Tonight, and you do winner of this match, I'll go for that crown for a second time. I'm sure management wouldn't mind another one of your match tonight.
Wait. Not right now. Management is in my ear. They're saying, okay, you can have a match, but not right now.
Happy face.
Fine.
So I guess the match of Dominic, the American, Brian, and of course Chip, who has amazing insults, will be squaring off later tonight.
Okay, Miss Giggles. But if that bitch is gonna be in Dominic's
corner,
Brian, don't call me Miss Giggles.
Be in Dominic's corner, then guess what? My wife is in mine.
Hey, guess what, Brian? Run!
Oh shit.
Oh, hang on. Somebody else wants to talk.
Oh no. Absolutely does not make up with it in personality. So those three guys, I'm going to let them work that out. I'm absolutely going to let them work that out because, as I proved just 2 days ago, give or take, after a long decontamination shower, I gave even Beckett Winter a shot at this crown because that's what I believe in. See, I don't believe you need to suck up to management or, you know, incestually blow them in order to get a shot at a championship. Or in this case, the crown, something that holds a hell of a lot more weight than a belt. And tonight, I wanted some competition, but I realized all of my competition is busy trying to fight amongst themselves to see who's going to step up next. So, to the three who came out, I wish you all the best. I truly do. Good luck, and Godspeed. Let's see who's going to come after me again. Anything can happen here in KOW, and no, you don't need to be besties with management. Thank you. And there you have it, the words of our king, who needs to go back into that decontamination shower, because I swear I can
give it to you. Fuck me, you get it on your own. Let's go deliver to you. Not open up the door to spell. The non-stop pop up, staying still. No heart getting busy with it. I got such a good heart, but I make the motherfucker one day again. Damn right, but I do it again. Yeah, I am right, so I got to win.
after I lock up. Alright, are we ready for match two, everybody? Yes? No? Maybe so? Well, I am ready.
Of course!
Alright, so first to the ring. He hails from El Paso, Texas. He stands at 6'9", weighs 295 pounds. He's the king of KOW. His name is Xander Garcia, the X-Factor.
Yay, more of the protein thing.
Good lord. Alright.
Uh-oh, did somebody play whack-a-mole?
I think so. Alright, so we're to match three. It was stated a little bit earlier. No whack-a-moles this time. So this is going to be a triple threat match. Now, I hope these guys are still here. Anyway. First to the ring, he's from Devil's Fork, West Virginia, USA. He stands at 6 foot tall, weighs 225 pounds. He's the real American, Brian Bennett, with his wifey, Izza.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God. Indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We have America, Brian Bennett in the ring. Next up, he hails from Las Vegas, Nevada, USA. He stands at 6'3". He weighs 240 pounds. He is the master of insults, the playboy, Chip and Dale.
I can't help it. The song just moves me. We'll be right back. Say good luck.
And last, but not least in this triple threat match, he hails from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania in the USA. Why is all people in the USA? What the heck? He stands at 6'8". He weighs 280. All right, we have all three contestants in the ring. The American, we have the Cyber Skull, and we have the Playboy, all from the United States of America, and this is going to be an interesting match. Hey, you gerbils, let's go.
Yes, will it be the porn star, the battery-operated boyfriend, or the redneck?
And we're all out of the ring. Chip takes down Brian Bennett. Dominic is kind of hovering. I wonder what's going on.
Well, it looks like a northern lariat.
Ah, well, he did something. Knocked the guy down right on his thumbs. And there's Chip in the ring. And Dominic has Brian by the hair. That's okay. It's only Brian.
Ooh, looks like he performed one of his signature moves, the system crash. Looks like they're both teaming up on the American right away.
It is. It looks like it.
Ooh, a leg lariat from Chip.
It seems that Brian is out of the match right now. Guess he's laying there taking a nap while Chip and Dominic go at it in the squared circle. Yeah, Brian's going to take a rest. Maybe he needs a lollipop. I don't know.
I'm sure after he goes up against Chip, he'll be given some plenty to suck on.
Dun, 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 dun.
We have an Irish whip into the ropes, followed by a big boot. That didn't go as well as Chip intended.
No, it didn't.
Ooh, a facebreaker from Chippendale.
Brian falling around the ring.
Right,
we got an Irish whip
into the ropes. And an inverted atomic drop.
Awesome. Chip has great, great insults.
Ooh, a jawbreaker. Dominic trying to get himself back in this match.
Oh, Brian's up.
Okay, it looks like another Irish whip. And an overhead belly-to-belly.
Yeah, Marika is alive and well.
Right now, Brian Bennett looks more like a morning wood. Just kind of standing there stiff until you take the piss out of it.
Yeah, and there goes the piss. Dominic not paying attention to Chip, which is very bad for him.
Ooh, and he gives Dominic the one-night stand.
Dominic's going to feel that in the morning. Maybe he needs some Midol.
Or a morning after pill?
Maybe. Where Izzo's trying to get Brian up. He's trying and not getting much going with Brian. Maybe you should get him a burger or something. That might get him up.
All right, an Irish whip to the corner. Oh, this could be bad.
Brian's up. Brian's up. Brian's in the ring, and Chip has seen him, as Dominic is in the corner. Not looking too good for one. Maybe his batteries are running low. Maybe Malice needs to change them.
Maybe she needs to plug something in and hand crank him.
Yeah, maybe. Okay, that just really break Brian's jaw.
I don't know, I heard something break.
So did I. Oh, Chip's in the other corner. Here he comes. Full head of steam, and
he gives him the deep throat. It's going to be a long time washing that taste out of his mouth. Oh, a double deep throat. Going for that porn star action. As Chip proves he doesn't need a fluffer.
Chip grounding up on Dominic, and in comes the pitch, and oh, strikeout with a drop toe hold.
Yikes, that looked painful.
Well, head bouncing off a turnbuckle sure isn't a good thing. Gives you kind of a headache.
I remember how that feels. It's not fun. And I'm a clown. We know fun. That's not fun.
Brian going up against Malice right now. Malice gives him a beautiful shot to the lid. And down he goes, and she's Oh boy. And in the ring, Dominic is beating up on Chip. Malice is beating up on Brian. Iz is looking worried. And I need popcorn. Ooh, Malice taking out Brian's leg. That's not good. Chip is kind of in a whole heap of trouble there. His back is hurting him. Dominic is stalking. I don't know who the hell he's stalking right now, but he's stalking somebody. He's
Ooh,
looking at
he
both guys.
Had enough.
Aha. Oh, he's going back to Chip. Okay. Iz had enough. Now she's squaring up against Malice, and whoa! Big shot to the face of Malice. Oh, here we go.
Looks like we have a scoop slam happening over there by Dominic.
Brian back on his butt.
Brian proving that he just can't keep it up.
And everybody's at everybody right now. We've got Iza versus Malice. Who got booted right off. We've got Dominic, who's beating the crap out of Chip. And Brian, who's kind of... yeah. Being Brian. Round and pound.
One should never underestimate the power of clown magic.
Dominic seems to be controlling this match right now, but here comes Brian. Head full of steam. Maybe not.
That looks like a front face lock. Malice has returned from the cornfield.
Yep. I guess she's got some corn with her. See, now if I was Dominic, I would have thrown Chip right into Brian. Oh, he did.
Uh-oh,
and there goes the...
I just saw something naughty.
Mm-hmm, me too. Oh! Now that's what the crowbar got whacked by Iza. Iza's not turned... shining down from this, and Dominic knocked both men right in the kisser.
Used that stinger splash.
Dominic taking control of the match.
As the ladies prove that they've got what it takes. And do a little ground and pound over there.
Dominic going after Brian.
The crowd giving themselves a little self-love.
Yeah, self-love. Here we go.
Obviously, they're enjoying the show. We got a front face lock happening in the ring. And a rough pickup going on outside of it. Ooh, looks like one of my moves. Giving Brian a choke.
Chips up. And chip. Wow. Beauty kick right to the mush.
Yay.
So who do you want to win this match?
You know, really, I'm kind of hoping for Chip.
Me too.
I mean, I don't like the company he keeps.
But oh, we got a pin. 1, 2.
Only a 2 count.
Brian just got out of that. That was like 2.99999999.
You just had to bring her up, didn't you, Opie?
Oh my goodness. Chip is trying. He's trying hard. Both other men are down for the count, but they still won't let him win. Dominic needs its jump start. Brian needs a cheeseburger, and Chip needs a condom.
No, he likes to ride bareback, can't you tell?
Ah. Chip needs to be disinfected.
Ooh, performs the closing act. But Brian comes in with a Give Me Liberty or DDT.
Wow. Brian's left standing. Oh my goodness. This is crazy. Pin, Brian, pin.
Can he capitalize on it?
Can
he? Is he smart enough to capitalize on it?
We're hoping so. Pin. Come on, Brian. Pin.
Come on, Brian. You can do it. Three-letter word. Rhymes with Ben.
Oh, we got a pin.
There he goes.
And we got a 1, a 2, a 3.
My God.
Your winner and the one up for Xander is Mr. America, Brian Bennett.
Oh, my Lord.
Well, that was a good match,
ladies and gentlemen, and all things in between. We have our contender, Brian Bennett.
Oh, none of y'all thought I could do it, and I did. Just because I talk like this does not mean that I'm stupid.
I'm two
of the best men in this company.
May think that beating them makes you not stupid, but marrying your cousin does.
This is not my cousin last time I checked.
Hey, remember what I told you earlier? You might want to do it again. Run, you little bitch, run!
Well, in a surprise win, it was Brian Bennett, and he's the one that gets to go up against the king.
Get your ass out of here, come on.
Alrighty, that was a surprise ending. I was surprised. Were you surprised?
Yes, I was. I was not expecting that to happen at all.
Alrighty. So, are we ready for the main event?
I'm ready.
Well, looks like we're ready for the main event. I'm just waiting for management to tell me so.
Now, you said you had a little trouble with those Japanese names. Did you want me to give that a crack?
Yeah, you do that, because I just can't do Japanese names.
Right, then I'll go ahead and handle the announcing on the first two, and you can take care of the last two. How's that?
Works for me, bud.
You know, normally we have someone get into the ring, and since this is the main event, I'll go ahead and do that.
Okay, you go do that, since you look cuter than I do right now.
Hello there.
Uh-oh, somebody wants to talk there, sweetheart. Hang on. Guess what? We're gonna hear it again. He comes from El Paso, Texas. He stands at 6'9". He weighs 295 pounds. He is the king of KOW. Oh my goodness. It is the king, Xander Garcia. I guess he wants to talk about Brian winning.
Alrighty then, I can wait.
Justin, I guess we have another match.
Well, the more the merrier.
I know. So, his opponent, he's from the Briggs compound. He stands at 6'2". He weighs 208 pounds. He is Damian Briggs Hex.
What's up, Danger?
We got some two big baddies in the ring today.
Okay. Well, this should be real interesting.
Mm-hmm. Damien versus Xander. This should be a good match.
These are both really, really hardy competitors.
Yeah, they are.
We've seen lots of them in several matches.
Yeah, this is a good matchup, I think, personally. And we're off! Xander comes straight in with a lockup.
Not giving his opponent any time, and that's the way you want to do it. Ooh, sweet combo punches.
Well, that took the breath out of Xander.
Well, that's what you want to do. You don't want to be stuck in that corner. I'm sure, you know, as an experienced wrestler yourself, you know that is not the place to be unless you're the one putting them there.
Of course I put them there.
You know, I'm starting to like you.
And we've got some reversals going on, which is good, because this means that it's going to be a really good match, and it's probably going to be clean and by the book, which is really boring. Face lock. Picking the gut.
Back to a lock.
Yeah.
Jinx.
You owe me a Pepsi. Anyway. A front face lock. Mr. Xander. Yes, the king. The king. The king. Huge. Huge fists going up against Xander. Which you kind of need, because you gotta ring his bell sometime. There he goes! And I got that song ringing my bell. Thank you, Yuki.
You're welcome. Just don't ask where I was keeping it.
I don't want to know. And I guess Xander hit James. James is not looking too good over there. And Damien's taking advantage of the whole situation, which is good. Because he should.
Well, of course. If the referee's not paying attention, everything's legal.
Of course it is. Oh, Xander comes out of the corner like a raging bull and flying shoulder block. Is X-Way talking?
Ah.
Oh, hello.
Oh. Right in the biscuits.
Oh my. Xander's gonna be screaming a little bit like a little girl. Is James trying to shake it off. Damien.
Xander's trying to figure out why it now feels like it's tied like a balloon animal.
Damian taking advantage of that, which is good.
Hitting him with a shining lizard. So now both heads hurt.
Yeah. Xander's still clapping the boys, so to speak.
Gotcha.
James. Oh.
Ooh.
He got him. He got him, but he got himself too. I guess the boys are still hurting. James is still down. Oh my goodness. This is going to be wonderful. Wonderful match. Wonderful match. Boys a little tender, Xander. Or die. Damien up. Back to a lockup. Wrenching wrist lock. Oh, we got another wrist lock. Arcana seems to want to come out as Xander's in the ring, because Arcana has a whole bunch of stuff to say to him. But yeah, drop toe hold. Knock Xander right on his nose. So now his face hurts, his boys hurt, his head hurts. Damien, off the ropes. Beautiful leg drop. Right in the gut. Xander slowly getting up. And another clean lockup by our king.
And there's another hug.
Uh-oh,
he's going for that wrist.
Yeah, James is twitching. I think he's getting up.
Well, we all know what happens when Xander starts going for that arm.
He's tenderizing it.
Like a steak.
Oh, there you go. Greco-Roman eye rake. But Xander, I think he got pissed off about that one.
Yeah, he did.
James looking a little... worn for wear there, poor guy. Xander's still on that arm. Oh! That's gotta hurt.
That hurt me looking at it.
I know, it did me too. Ugh. Big slaps. And down we go.
There it is, the X-Lock, and he's got it locked in.
And there's nowhere for Damien to go. Damien screaming. I don't blame him, because that looks sore.
Yeah, well, he's worked on that arm, and now he's got a choice. He can tap it, or he can let it pop. There it went.
There it went. I heard it.
That arm is toast.
That's the second, third, fourth. How many wrestlers has he knocked out?
Yep. Just waiting to hear from our referee. And there it is. Your winner, Xander. By...
All right, I think we have to do sponsors before the main event. You want to do them again?
Sponsors. We read the sponsors.
Okay. We don't do them again?
No, we usually only do them once. But, you know, I do have one thing to say, though.
Sure.
If Damian decides to start a life of crime, he's going to have to go by the name Slots. Because now he's a one-armed bandit.
I like it. All right. Are we ready for the main event now, peoples?
Well, let's find out from the back. Are we ready?
All right, we're ready. Do you want to do the first two and I'll do the last two? You're looking really cute in the ring with your attire.
Alrighty, let's bring them up.
This is your KOW main event, brought to you by Air. Yes, Air.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our main event. This is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. On my left, we have, at 130 pounds, standing at 5'5", from Kimiji Village in Okigahara, Japan, the maiden of Dawn Sakura, Lita McPherson. And her partner, standing at 5'9", weighing 130 pounds, also from Himeji, Japan, the maiden of Dawn's Susan, Akira Reinhardt. And for their opponents, standing to my right, standing at 5'7", at a weight of 150 pounds, from Pendle Hill, UK, Katie Carter! And last but not least, standing at 5'6" tall, weighing 155 pounds from Central Europe's Asylum City, the current reigning queen of KOW, the Dark Siren, Samantha Foxy!
This should be a really good match. Have a couple of newer girls here, which should be really, really good. I want to see how well they do against the Queen and the Katie. Sounds like a fairy tale. But yeah.
Well, I do know that those two shrine maidens have been hunting my clowny little butt for quite some time.
Oh my.
But they are up against the Queen and Katie Carter, both of whom I faced, and I believe both of them have faced as well. And it's going to be a tough match. They're going to have a lot to prove out there.
I've squinted my eyes to see if Katie was wearing pants.
yeah, but that's okay.
Katie always wears a little bit of a risque type outfit, but it always looks good on her.
Yes, the emphasis is on a little bit.
Yeah, very little bit. Katie in stance. Oh, they're circling each other.
I have noticed a lot more pink of late. I'm wondering if I'm affecting the fed.
I don't think we're gonna get Arcana to wear pink. Purple, black. That's Arcana.
You never know. For some reason, my pink seems to be infecting a whole bunch of people.
Yeah, you never know.
Even Ophi's eyes turned pink for a little while.
Oh my.
Oh, ooh.
Yeah, but that was a medical condition. Rena doing really well against Katie. Beautiful.
No, the leg drop.
Exactly. Katie looking a little winded.
Looking like they're both a little winded, but that's all right. That's to be expected, you know. You gotta come out strong.
Yeah, you do.
Right now, there's a lot going on in their minds. Especially with the tag team.
Yep. But Rena being the nice person she is helps.
Hey, well, yeah. I remember our very first debut match. Rena and I were in a tag team match with Jim Green and Anarchy.
Oh my. Anarchy. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, she was my tag team partner.
Off the ropes we go.
And a wrist lock.
Well, you were lucky to have my sister as your partner.
Yeah, she threw me in the arena.
Yeah, she pretty much throws everybody everywhere.
But then I get Rena. And drank her blood.
For Rena.
I think she liked it. Looks like we got a hammerlock going on here as Katie starts showing the Shrine Maiden a few moves here and there.
Keeping it clean.
Well, that's kind of what I expect of these four. I don't expect to see a lot of dirty tricks. I expect to see a lot of technical and a lot of showmanship. But I'm not expecting to see anything naughty. It's not like either of us are in the ring.
That's true.
A knee to the gut. Once again into the ropes.
And beautiful.
Lovely drop kick. Well, that's a different kind of ring, Ophi.
That's a different kind of naughty, so.
Yes, welcome to the Kingdom of Wrestling.
And we have a pin.
Yes, we do. Welcome to the Kingdom of Wrestling, where TMI is not just a regular occurrence, it's
one,
a real life.
One, two. No, only a two. Wow, that was close. Rena had Katie down for a two count. That was really, really close.
Like I said, both of these girls have really been struggling to make a name for themselves in the KOW. They've been training really hard.
It shows. They're doing really well. A leg kick. Well, when they're taller than you, how do? You chop them down like a tree. Leg kicks are wonderful.
Yep. Well, you know, they're doing their best.
Doing very well. I think they are good up-and-comers that are going to be a pair to be reckoned with.
Yes, and there we have an Irish whip to the corner. Looks like a little bit of last-minute maneuvering. Got whipped to one corner, rolled to the other to get over to a partner. Rena following suit. A little bit of chaos out there, but that's always good. Caden taking the chance to get out of the ring and take a rest. This will be a true test of Reyna's resolve, as she, of course, has been in the ring from the start, while Sam is a fresh opponent. Already, again, we've got some more technical action happening. Looks like she's working on that backflip escape and reversing that lock. That looks like Rina's reversed it again. Actually quite surprised. Oh, Irish whip into the corner. Alrighty, looks like the queen rolled out as the tag has been made, and Akira becomes the leading person in the ring. Akira opens up with some flurries of punches. And going for a strike. And a Russian leg sweep. Akira is definitely showing her skills here. Taunting the queen and getting an answer with a vicious chop. Oh, going for a pin. Oh, and only getting a two count. They're showing she's really got something still in the tank. Queen throws a toe kick. And there's the tag. Looks like we had a toss. Oh, ask him how that arm is from last week. Going to work on it again. as the ladies banter a little bit back and forth, locking in that arm. Akira forcing her way back up. Ooh, she showed some moxie. Knee strike. A knee to the gut. And then a drop kick. Alright, we got an Irish whip coming back off the ropes and hitting Katie with a big boot. Going in for them stomps, one of my personal favorites. Ooh, and then a ground tackle followed by some punches. Giving that girl some tenderizing. Referee going in to make sure that those are open fists. And she goes for the pin. Only a two count. Still, the Shrine Maidens are showing some moxie here, showing they've got what it takes, giving these veterans a run for their money. Our queen calling to Katie to get a tag to get back in. Oh! But Katie Carter opens up with a flurry of kicks. Showing the rookies that they've still got a few tricks they haven't been taught yet. Tosses Akira into the corner. This cannot bode well. Oh! Hits her with the Inzaguri combo. Putting the Shrine Maiden on the floor. There's the tag as Sam comes in as the legal member. Get the shove back into the corner. Another Inzaguri combo. Looks like the Shrine Maidens are going to need someone to give them some chanting and help them get themselves fired up. Akira comes back with a big boot. Looks like she's putting her in the corner. Going ahead and giving her them punches in the face. Referee started the count. Smart move. Backs up. Breaks the count. She yells out, not enough. And moves back into the corner. Smashing that head right into the turnbuckle. Oh, and a beautiful snake eyes right off the turnbuckle. She's giving the queen a run for her money. Looks like Akira's decided she's had enough. She tags, bring Lena back in. Alrighty, we have the tag. Rhea is now the legal person in the ring. Queen is still on the ground. So far, the two Shrine Maidens have proven that they can give out a decent punishment. Let's see if they can capitalize on this and close the deal. These two girls could certainly use a win. And there it is, a figure four leg lock in the center of the ring. Looks like Rena's got that locked in. Referee's checking it. Checking to see if Samantha's going to give up. Katie's over here on the edge, pacing, watching her opponent. Nope. And there we go. Vaulting moonsault to break the hold. Referee's giving the count, telling Katie to get out. Referee's up to four, both ladies are getting up. Rena makes the tag. Rena calls to Akira to finish it. Oh! Queen delivers some vicious chops over onto Akira. Got a front face lock now. Let's see what Her Majesty plans on doing. Oh! Headbutt to get out of it. Little Irish whip. Oh! Into the corner. But not the corner they want. One, two. There's a tag. Carter now, the legal person in the ring, with Akira. Looks like there's a little conversation going on. Katie not really watching. Will the Shrine Maiden capitalize is the question. Can she do it? Does she have what it takes in her to do it? Strike her down and become more powerful. And yay, there she goes. 1, 2, and 3. As we wait for the official decision. And there you have it, our winners of this main event. By pinfall, Akira and Rina, the Shrine Maidens, have triumphed. And there you have it, another great show.